Hello everybody, and today we are going to discuss some important concepts of water resources engineering. And to know any area's discharge, maximum discharge, we should start beginning with understanding what is a catchment or a watershed or basin. And if this is the catchment where we are interested in measuring rivers maximum discharge, whose tributaries or streams are existing in the catchment. Now, there are many methods wherein we estimate the design flood, and a design flood is a most important factor to consider while constructing a hydraulic structure like dams, reservoirs, etc. So, for estimating the design flood, we need to know what is the maximum discharge occurring in the catchment. For that, we have various formulae, like we have been having empirical formulae developed by many scientists which directly give away the maximum discharge, and we have rational formula to find out the maximum discharge, and then we have unit hydrograph method, we have envelope curve method, probability and statistical method, and increase in rainfall method. Let us focus on rational method, which is applicable when the intensity of rainfall is greater than equal to time of concentration. Let us first try to understand what is a time of concentration. So, if we observe a catchment, if you take the most isolated part of the catchment, and when the rainfall is happening, the maximum discharge is measured at the outlet. And to this outlet discharge, when the remotest point of the catchment is contributing its discharge to the outlet discharge, and the time taken for the rainfall to flow from the remotest point to the outlet point where the discharge is being measured, that time is called time of concentration. So, if the intensity of rainfall is greater than equal to that time of concentration, then you are going to apply rational formula method. The rational formula says the Q maximum is equal to 2.778 times C into A into I, where C stands for the coefficient of the runoff, and it depends upon various regional factors where the runoff is being measured in the catchment, as well as A is the area of the catchment which is usually taken in kilometer square units, and I, which is the intensity of rainfall kept in centimeter per hour. So here the intensity of rainfall depends upon time of concentration, and scientist Kirpik has developed the formula to give the time of concentration. Time of concentration TC is equal to 0.0195 into the length of the catchment L to the power 0.77 into the slope of the catchment to the power of minus 0.385, where S is the slope in the between the two points, which can be given as delta H by L, where delta H is any two points of different heads H1 and H2. H1 and H2 divided by the length between the two points will give us the slope. So, after getting the length of the catchment and the delta H, you are going to calculate numerically what is the time of concentration. And depending upon the time of concentration, if the known intensity of the rainfall is greater, then you are going to apply rational method to find out the design flood or the design discharge. Thank you.